Good day and welcome to our second best of three series for the ESL One Manila Chinese pre-qualifiers. Not the qualifiers, but the pre-qualifiers. So you have to win this to get into the main qualifiers. And here we are for now, our second best of three series, VG Gaming Reborn versus TongFu. My name is Hades and I will be your caster for this best of three series, like the previous one. So guys, what's up? I'm from Singapore. Yep, it's pretty late here, but it doesn't matter because when I see Dota, you just gotta get hyped. So here we go. I'm actually really excited with VG Gaming Reborn's new lineup. I mean, I see FY, Nono, Yang, DDC, and End. I mean, a couple of months ago when I casted a couple of Chinese games, I mean, not to mention, I mean, VG Gaming Potential, they were pretty strong compared to, I mean, like, to the other tier 2 Chinese teams. They were really lived up to the name of having potential. And Ice, I mean, yeah, I'm a bit salty that he's no longer with the team, but still, hey, loving the new logo, looks pretty cool. And I mean, it's a bit odd, I'm not sure that it's supposed to be a VOR, like VOR or RAW or something, but anyways, back to the Dota. Here we are, we can see VG Gaming Reborn with FY being the drafter. It's always interesting to see how he is as a drafter, because back with the previous VG, I remember everyone was saying, I mean, mostly, I'm not sure whether Daryl was, I mean, Ice was trolling, but you know, it's like whatever FY get once he gets. And it's interesting to see how he is right now in the captain, in the position of, in the role of a captain and a drafter. So here we are, VG Gaming, the first big Beastmaster, very very nice here for that isolation of BKB carriers. Like I mentioned, it's, you know, it's magic immune, it pierces magic immunity, it's really strong. And just a hero in general of the Necrobooks, he can deal a ton of damage, especially since, you know, your Necrobooks have been buffed, like, I'm not sure how many times. I'm not even sure why we still don't see the Necrobook patch, which I was pretty confident was going to come. I mean, when you see Death Prophet coming in,
5 seconds
still
remaining.
I'll take it, it's close enough. But here we are, Vengeance Ven, it's always nice
reserve
to see.
Time.
Venge is there as the backup plan. You have, you know, Sven, just your Rogue Knight over here, so much strength, a free battle fury, with the, especially with the Quelling Blade, which I'm pretty sure it's going to get nerfed sooner or later with the stun or something. So he's going to be able to clear camps very, very quickly, ancients very quickly, and I'm not surprised if TongFu come up with something like a Dark Seer or maybe even a Magnus. There's something to just group them up together, or just more lockdown, which, you know, plain and simple. But the good thing about the Sven is, even if you're like, say, even a lane of Rax down, he farms so darn quickly. I think with that Cleave build, I've tried it out quite a number of times, pretty much averaged like an average 800 GPM kind of thing in ranked games. It's pretty fun to see, because that's just how quickly this guy farms. It's like, it's really, really good. So anyways, yeah, Invoker banned out, and VG Gaming taking a lot of time out, just making sure they're not disconnected. Alright, so FY, I mean, what do you guys think? Do you guys have any ideas? I mean, we've seen funny stuff like that Wind Ranger support, which he has sort of paid off. I mean, if, even if you try to Queen of Pain support, I'm not surprised if that even comes out, but we'll go for something a bit more related to this meta. It's going to be an Enchantress pick, so that's great for the early pressure.
Dire,
and if you guys have been following Dota Pit, of course, you know, like, if you've been watching Art Style, I believe, yeah, he got an amazing rampage with the Enchantress, and of course, if any of you were watching that exact moment, you would have been crazy. Because the power of the impetus is just so strong with the Dragon Lance. You've got the Aghanim Scepter as well. It's really, really crazy.
5 seconds remaining.
Alright, so, I mean, at the same time, here we are back
reserve
to this game.
Time.
The draft, not much you can see, but TongFu also taking their time. I mean, yeah, they've cut so much into the reserve time. I'm actually a bit worried that. Alright, just hold on.
Radiant team ban.
Alright, so there we go. And okay, sorry about that. Just having a bit of issues in the background. I understand you guys missing out while you heard
remaining.
The heroes and stuff. Sorry about that. There's a 2-minute delay and it can be
Five
a bit problematic
remaining.
To synchronize these things. Alright, so VG Gaming did take out the Chen,
reserve
afraid of
time.
That early push, which I would say it goes quite well to Sven, of course, with the Warcry as well. It makes your creeper so much tankier.
Hmm.
You've got great damage in the Vengeance Aura. It's There's just so much synergy between these picks so far. And of course, I mean, okay, this is a bit random, just saying, but if you've noticed the color scheme of the heroes, it's almost like the dire side, you know, it's your dark side. VG game, this is like almost like a Lord of the Rings matchup for the two heroes. Enchantress and Beastmasters, like your elves, your wood elves, you know, versus
5 seconds remaining.
Your orcs and stuff like that.
Dire team pick.
Alright, so anyways, yeah, you can see here, Lone Druid always a good offlaner to just ban out because he's so good at isolating. And you take out the Ember Spirit as well. VG Gaming, you take out the Witch Doctor, very comfortable support, which FY probably does not want to play against, which can be very, very annoying if you get a few lucky coconuts off. But Pugna! Alright, I'm not sure what's the logic behind this Pugna pick, but it's going to be interesting to see. Do they have any nuke? I mean, I guess one way you can think about it is that if VG Gaming go for this like really, really strong physical damage kind of build, you go with the Decrepify. You save this Sven, and your Pugna can pretty much just stand in the back lines, you know, just providing tons of HP and sustainability to the Sven.
Reserve time.
Alright, so third pick.
10 seconds remaining.
I'm kind of worried about VG Gaming's lack of control for now. I mean, yeah, it's still too early to tell into the drafting phase, but it's still fun to watch. And there we go, we will see the Rubik.
Dire team pick.
Spells to steal, you've got two stuns, you've got always a nice tower nuke.
Legion commander!
And, oh.
Radiant team pick.
Whew. Okay, this is interesting. I mean, press the odds. Coming up, combined with Sven. You think about it, that extra erratic damage, you're like bish, 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 and it's like, or whatever cosmetic he's using, it's really, really OP. Alright, so I mean, at the same time,
10 seconds remaining.
Coming out. I don't know, but so far, I can just say TongFu has been very surprising, very. Yeah, it's just not. They just deviated so far from their standard meta. Legion Commander is somewhat there. It's not always there. Liquid plays a bit of Legion Commander in the plus 4 role.
5 seconds remaining.
Pugna mid. I mean, VG Gaming, they have not exposed who their mid hero
Radiant
is yet, but they have gone for that Juggernaut mid. So Juggernaut safe lane, sorry. So that's good to see. I mean, Omni Slash, isolating carry. Isolating a hero in general, but of course they did Decrepify. You see, that's where the Pugna seems to shine even more as pick.
10 seconds remaining.
So Wind Ranger is going to be taken out.
5 seconds
None
remaining.
Of these teams have picked up OD. OD is just left there. Death Prophet is still left there. These two heroes are just left
Reserve
there.
Time.
I don't get it. Is there something going on in the Chinese meta which I am not aware of?
Dire team pick.
Because OD is really strong here against heroes like Sven and Juggernaut. It'd be great on either of these teams just because of their low mana pools. And one hit to the Jug, you take away his intelligence, and he's not gonna have mana for the Omni Slash. He's just stuck there spinning around. And yeah, you can spin me right around all you want, but it's not gonna do anything. And it will be the Death Prophet. So TongFu going for something,
Radiant team pick.
Something similar to that kind of push strat, which is really, really strong. And of course with the Spirit Siphon as well, it's gonna be great against heroes like your Beastmaster, your Juggernaut. Okay, both these teams have very highly, you know, high skill drafts. It really requires you to pull off perfect execution. And anything a bit out is just going to screw things up, like maybe the momentum of the fights. But still, it's going to be really interesting seeing how the synergy
remaining.
Works. I mean, TongFu, I can understand the synergy. VG Gaming is a bit more simplistic.
5 seconds
it's not
remaining.
As sophisticated compared to TongFu's drafts, but still, it's pretty good just by having their early control.
Zeus.
And it would be the Zeus. So there's your strong nuke. FY Gone has disappointed me, guys. I was kind of expecting to see something a bit more funky. Alright, so VG Gaming Reborn. Who do you guys think will win here? I mean, just from the draft alone, I kind of favor VG Gaming. Not because I'm a VG fan gay, but because, you know, I mean, okay, I'm not an FY fan gay as well. For those of you thinking it. I was thinking it for a moment there as well, but I just want to say that, I mean, the draft is just easier to execute, it's more simplistic. It's not as tough compared to TongFu. Alright, so there we go. Game 1 versus TongFu versus VG Gaming Reborn. And here, introducing on the Radiant side for Yang. He's going to be playing on the Beastmaster. We're going to have End playing on the Juggernaut, following by DDC on the Rubik, FY God playing on the Enchantress, and No playing on the Zeus. Nice Arcana. On the Dire side, we're going to have Triple U9 playing on the Sven. Lin playing on the Death Prophet. We're going to have DDR playing on your Vengeful Spirit with Faith on the Legion Commander. And trotting off behind him, we're going to see LPC playing on the support Pugna. Alright, so there we go. No early TP to put down wards just yet. Yang, no Iron Talon. Disappointing. Yeah, one thing I realized is that the Chinese teams are not really so open to buying the Iron Talon just yet. Alright. So Faith with an LC mid?
30 seconds.
Who's got the double
to
tangos? It feels like the Death Prophet's the one going mid. Yeah, he's got the pool of tangos. And the bow is just gonna scout them out. Over here, Nano embrace the Arcana. You pick Zeus with Arcana because Zeus Arcana wins you games apparently. Kappa. Anyways, here we're gonna see a nice level 1 engage in the bottom lane and already going in to press the up. Doesn't really work. And there we go, he's gonna spin, he's not gonna kill the Pugna, but Death Prophet and Faith did this, go charging in, trying to go for FY. He's got a level 1 enchant, but that's not gonna do much because it can only slow your targets, and it's gonna be its bounty rune going. Both bounty runes going to TongFu. Stolen right under FY's nose. Alright, so Yang using his boar, he's gonna crack the whole creep wave, and he actually cancels the salve! That's huge! Because now he's not going to be able to sustain in lane that easily. I mean, yeah, he has a ton of tangos, but that's it. And judging from the lane matchup, he's going to be very happy. He's not going to be happy because of the dual lanes. But DDR is here to salvage the situation. It looks like the original plan. Maybe he was to just go and get stack. Stacks. And then Chantress is going to get the first blood on the Legion Commander, missing first blood. Yikes. Alright, so FY, immediate impact, which is way too soon. You don't usually see Enchantresses like making that, forcing these rotations because it's just so risky. And Lin already has an advantage over the Zeus, has a bottle on the way, I believe. So one of them going the way of VG Gaming Reborn. Yang has an edge here because of the double board. Cutting DDR around. This is quite nice, and he's already level 2. And of course, because this is not a tri-lane, it's not going to be easy for DDR to really zone him out. An off-lane LC. I'm interested to see how this works out, because by overwhelming odds... Yeah, because I always get these skill names messed up, my bad. Okay. But anyways, yeah, I mean, it's a nice nuke. It's great for going up against, like, it's going to do more damage because of the Enchanted Screams. No, Beastmaster actually gets a solo kill, and he may be able to kill U9, but Yang's gonna give him a solo kill. Nice comeback kill, actually, and that was really, really close, but the Boar's still doing a ton of damage, slowing him down. Oh, it's not gonna be enough. Actually, it may be enough. Alright, so one for one trade, but Yang's still getting a nice kill there. I mean, it would have been better if he got the kill on U9, but he's gonna get selfed up, and Juggernaut's gonna give himself another kill bottom lane. What the hell? Faith just feeding away in this lane, and FY pushing this lane to its maximum potential. And Lin just zoning out No.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Golden Seekling. I think those go for like, what, $200? Yeah. Anyway, LPC, yeah, he's not happy that Faith is dying, but still. I think the original plan was to try and push out this lane quite easily with the nukes, but it's not really been working out for them. The Crapify hasn't been that useful. Nether Ward. And No just bottle crowing because he can't really fight against Lin, who with Magic Wand, he actually. Oh, I think he may go for a solo kill! Ah, one more hit! And he gets his bottle just in the nick of time, so Lin diving for that but not really getting the kill. And does he have a bottle on the way? Nope, not yet. That was just a casual salve. So DDR, naked. No. career up yet. And he's gonna buy a smoke. But here's the troublesome part, because I'm not sure what's the synergy there in terms of the ganks. I guess that the decrepify, you can make your stuns a bit more painful. For ganking? Yeah. So Yang making his way towards maybe, but yeah, it's gonna be like casual power treads. And then he'll make his way into necro units. Faith is gonna be soloing this lane, it seems. Yep, they're gonna smoke LPC and DDR. With the nuke, hopefully they can kill this Beastmaster, who is quite tanky. He has a salve, so he's okay if he gets out just narrowly. Unite. Oh, here comes the nuke. The Nether Blast is followed, but he doesn't have the stun. Body blocks of DDR doing very, very well to keep him there. The decrepit fire and the nuke. One more Reckless. Yang is gonna fall here. Delves up, saves himself, but Nuz just barely in Punga. And here comes FY. He's gonna bring some of the Juggernaut. Let's get a kill at bottom. And here comes the Hadouken. Oh, the Seder gonna bring an LPC. Gonna kill triple U9. He's gonna go for DDR instead. That could have been a double kill. That could have been huge. But Juggernaut gets himself a nice kill at the bottom lane. So it's a nice 1-for-1 trade, which that's sort of good way of TongFu. And then he's very, very low. Oh, throwing out the lightning bolt. He gets away. He's gonna have to be forced back to base as DDC chases him. And FY already with the face boost. This is just amazing. So he's doing okay in terms of net worth. As a support, you see he's doing so much better than the offlaners. He's doing better than Yang. Just guiding him here at the bottom and middle lane. LPC gets himself a kill on Nono, catching that just in the nick of time. But Yang doesn't have to roar. Oh, but here comes DDC. Hello, hello. Where are you running? Nowhere, apparently. And great vault. Graphite doesn't matter. DDR. Just helplessly watching from the top of the stairs as his teammate dies. And then back to the middle lane, happily farming. This Juggernaut has had a very easy time, 28 and 7. So you can see that the advantage they've created over here for your Juggernaut, he's had very, very good time. Compared to his Venus 20 and 0, threats, he's not gone for the max out B build. So he's gone for just a bit more value in terms of damage with the stun. FY, walking behind him, the Hellbear Smasher, DDC. Lin has to be very, very careful, but he's walking away because the... Oh, I think they scout this out. They're pinging him out. If he walks back up, I don't think he knows yet. He doesn't know. Hellbear's coming out. Exorcism is pop. Pelican is up. We're gonna try to toss him down river, but it's not gonna be able to lightning bolt. Lin's just gonna get smacked right down in between. FY gets out of 100 HP. Nature's Attendant's gonna take care of that sustainability. And LPC looking for, hoping for a cleanup kill. He's gonna tangle himself and nope, he's not gonna find anything else. So 7-3 as VG Gaming Reborn take a nice advantage and Faith LPP home out. So I mean DDC just waiting out there. FY very, very low, but the untouchable. Level 3, he's not getting any kills today. That's DDC. Faith's gonna get tossed back. Hellbear Smasher doing the body block. It's not gonna be there. Omni Slash falling. Decrepify saving him there. Just barely and nicely done. And one more vault. We have a level 6 ult. Zeus ult, maybe. There we go. Lightning Box finish him off. Not needed.
At least I gained the notice.
And just as all that has been happening in the bottom half of the map, Yang is already level 6 compared to your Legion Commander, who's still a meager level 4. LPC with Arcane Boots trying to push out this bottom lane, get whatever he can. And yeah, game just looks to be quite a bit of a disaster for TongFu as VG is pushing very, very quickly. And they want LPC. They know he's there, they need to telekinesis off. But being a Pugna, 380 movement speed, he's just so quick. Bait him with the courier maybe? Not seeing any of that. And Faith picks up an Iron Talon of his own, so he's gonna be farming the jungle. And Lin as well. I gotta admit, you don't usually see a level 6 Death Prophet putting more points into the value point into the Exorcism yet. I guess just now because he was like, why not? Maybe if someone TP'd, he could have gotten in a return kill. Would prefer to max out Soul Siphon or the Crypt Swamp. But anyways, here we go. Yang dominating this lane, DDR. Can't really do anything about it, and FY is already behind. Can he go for DDR? I think. Oh, he doesn't have Enchant just yet. He doesn't have a creep. But he's gonna zone DDR out. And just like that, he's brought down to 2/3 of his HP. DDC is gonna look for telekinesis, he won't find a lift, and this top lane is taking so much pressure. and this takes off all the stress away from the Juggernaut, who now has the Ring of Color and Phase Boots, 48-8, and he's happily farming with Easy Camp as well. All these wards from TongFu, they just haven't had the time or the space to just, you know, mobilize to the area. And there we go, Spirit Diver, no, juking through the trees maybe. Lightning Bolt pops up, oh, doesn't even get it off in the nick of time. And then the TP, that's a nice solo kill, Death Prophet, the Decrepify, doing value. Triple Yuan being slowed down very, very hard, but FYI, look at that impetus damage, he's looking for a bit more, but that armor. Then Warka, he's gonna find DDR, of course, with the Hawk! Dodge Jam's gonna be popped. Oh, the cleave! FYI's gonna pay for diving all the way too far in. Here comes the roar from Faith, 4. Oh, Zeus out kills off the bench, and here comes the Toucan coming up from the Seder. The Shockwave. Yang, I think he's okay. Why not? Just kidding. And right, the Seder, the Shock, looking for a bit more to heal up Lin. And DDC is gonna bring back LPT. Nice bolt from the Zeus. So Decrepify is not gonna save you. And meanwhile, Juggernaut can just happily continue to farm the bottom lane.
Dire's bottom tower.
Good free farm. He's just free farm. He's almost twice the CS of this event. There are no stacks in sight. He's very, very content with the farm up. So this will be a very easy T1, so you build below 50 to 10 HP. And FY, getting closer to those drums, and that's where we're going to see that Enchantress sort of transitioning to the core role.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Very close to his own fair share of Necro books, and then of course you have these piggies.
I'll take that as tribute.
I still don't understand how this is a boar. It looks nothing like a boar. If you think about it, it looks more like a wolf. And this will be the top T1. Quicker than it. End.
Dire's top
indeed, a smoke coming up from
fallen.
DDC and Nono. Will they find anybody? Nope. Looks like TongFu have just backed off in these very, very nice wards. Oh, looks like they will find Lin. The smoke pops. And the bot comes out. Maybe they'll find someone peeping in. They do the clip and the ult comes out, and then he just gonna fall. And hopefully, maybe they can find one more kill. Safe. He gets the duel to FY, who is not the ideal target, but here comes you. Nice. Look at that. Unpunchable. And no damage from anyone. After one charge, DDC, he takes the duel. Maybe he gets some spare damage here. Actually, no, he's not gonna give it away to Ben. That's the last person you wanna give it to. And look at all this. Oh, you don't wanna be too close, Triple U.
Dire structures are fortified.
Ooh, he's gonna turn him up. Faith. Coming 5. Pumped up last. And oh, he's gonna chase him down. DDR with the stun. No, does get the easy candle. And he's a land as well. He does the recipe just at the very end. And meanwhile, Yang happily pushing this top T2, which is. Wow, that's so fast. It's really gonna fall. Yeah, it's really within 9 range. Yikes. So there we go, there's gonna one more tower down, and that'll be the end of it. So this is 2 towers down, he's gonna get his Necro books very, very soon. And this means he can get more solo kills than heroes like Gepogna, who are just so squishy. And then he's at absolute free farm, like I mentioned, 79 assets to make that 80. And he's going for a casual Yasha. And okay, looks like Yang, he's going for the straight up push. FY, closer and closer to the drums. Zeus has done quite a fair bit this game, actually. He's gonna find himself a nice bounty rune at the same time.
Tower is under attack.
So I'm not sure if he's a support or core, because the way he's farming, he's more farm. He's like almost as farmed as Zeus. Let's take a quick look at net worth. All the cores here are doing so well, and you can see the economy distribution coming up between both these teams. As TongFu, they're kind of lacking behind. Your partner's the richest hero on their team. And here comes the blast. Smoke coming out, swap from end. Can they get the duel? Yep, they will. Oh, but the counter swap of DDC, and he needs an Omni Flash. Oh, but the life trade sucks him dry, and Legion Commander will be dead. They're going for DDC, and the Decrepify, the Pumpkin Blast, and the Spirit Siphon to follow. He's just gonna explode as the Pumpkin gets killed. And meanwhile, Yang is happily split pushing the top as, ooh, that's a lot of damage down from Triple U9. And Yang is thinking about coming back in. They have the Zeus out. I think they wanna go FY. He shows himself instead, and yep, this is what I was talking about. He was very, very low. In bottom lane, they have to make decisions. They're gonna pop the Exorcism to go get this T1, but the top lane is already at half HP. T3 at 13 minutes. Then FY does the math. He doesn't care. He just pops the Nature's Attendant and the double boars. Maybe this is his creep wave. And this is a very slow push. The TP's coming in from DDC. Maybe he's looking to try to push someone back, but actually, no. There we go. Omni Slash. They still have the Omni Slash! The pump is now. No. It is level 2, but this is no one else. And he gets the tower denied, so that's a lot of. That's a wasted ult. And a lot of gold being denied to them. And the Zeus actually gets the mid T1, so. Overall, I would say VG Gaming Reborn, they just, yeah, they're sort of behind by kills, but still, they're just getting these trades, which is favoring them. Alright, so he has a casual Yasha on the way, maybe a Sanj. And yeah, we're 14 minutes in, but if you lost. Log towers and a nice comfortable lead for VG Gaming Reborn. But TongFu, I still think they can come back into this because of the Sven. It's a Sven with drums. He wants to fight really, really early. Alright, so FY. Probably the Dragonlance or the Aghanim Scepter. And you can see right now, 11 to 12, this game is quite close, but because of all this extra gold flying into the piggy banks with the supports, VG Gaming are not afraid to just push on. Well, TongFu, their supports are kind of poor, except for the Pugna. This bench, playing the POS 6 it seems, and they're smoked up. They will try to look, and actually maybe if someone walks up the stairs, they may be able to find No-No. Apparently not, and actually no, they will find themselves another target, which will be FY, and the duel will follow with the Legion Commander picks himself. Nice, winner, winner, chicken dinner. And there we go. That was just bad timing, just walking in like that and just like bam. And this ward, yep, the Will Scarlet is new. Oh, actually not that new, it's still the one from just now. And now we're gonna see the 4-man smoke coming out from VG. I think they wanna go to the Crepid Plasma now. Shows everybody and the blasts and the roar, everything comes out and Faye blinks out just in the nick of time. As VG Gaming, they're looking for more blood, but the only blood they get is this very, very tasty puck. Alright, so they take out the Sentry and the Necro 2. Yeah, it's almost a Necro 3 at 15 minutes in, it's actually an impeccable timing of a nice deep ward to follow as well. VG Gaming, the plan is clear, it's simple, and they will just push for this mid T2. Which they will probably get. This is a good thing about the Beastmaster aura as well. With the inner beast, you can see like, how quickly this tower falls. So the push potential is really not something to laugh at. Although it seems like TongFu has somewhat a bit better edge in terms of push. I would say both these teams have very strong push lineups. And we see the Death Prophet hasn't really come online in terms of the exorcism. We've only seen one exo. In, all alone in the bottom, and this is a very bad place. They still have the exorcism and almost the Sanj completed. Oh, spots him out. They need to find him. He really needs to TP out, but he does have a TP. He's on cooldown and he will find Lin. Caught in the world, everyone in the purge. Oh wait, no, sorry, that's the Pugna Blast. What was I talking about? That's DDD. Okay, but anyways, yeah, they get themselves a very tasty kill on Death Prop. The Crobulus feeding away. Going to the bottom lane was not the play. And LPC is trying to do some chip damage to the mid tower, which is sort of working. Young. Almost on the Necrobooks. And N has the Sanj and Yasha completed. No battle for insight. And Yang, oh, Faith has no mana, so he's gonna get. Oh, DDR. There's no duel. It's even magic wand. There's mana for the duel. And actually, maybe to get the turning around, but triple U9. Actually, instead, it's gonna go killing up all these Necro units and bam, that's a lot of damage. Gets denied as well, FY. And they will get the mid to the bottom T1, and now it looks like they will go for the bottom T2. So all these objectives have been thrown out the window by TongFu. They're like, take it and go. And after that, here comes Crobulus, he's TPing in. Looking for a common kill, but actually, no, this will happily Nether Blast to clean up the creep wave. As Lin making her way towards the Yule Scepter. And Nono on 2.1k. Maybe a blink, we might see a veil. Alright, so the map is just torn wide open. You can see right now from VG Gaming, this is. Well, they don't really see much, but still, all the towers are gone. Under attack. And meanwhile, here from TongFu, they have a lot of defensive wards. They want absolute control of their jungle despite the towers not being there. So, kudos to them. Almost look like drums, almost. And there will smoke, so a 4-man smoke coming out, and the water here was the warded, so did you take it out? It was actually in range? Oh, okay. And Faith with the blink, they want to find Yang. Oh, they look like they will find themselves. No, no, instead. And the TP's coming in. EDC, looking for a counterplay. Not gonna find anything, but he's gonna get the steal from LPC, and what he get? He's gonna get the net award. Life drain. Oh, that's actually really good for him.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
FY is invis. Do they have sentry nearby? It's really, really scary. This is one of those points where you just casually trot in and hope that, you know, there's no ward there. Oh, and they're just blocking the pole, guys. That's just mean. So they know that the Sven is gonna be clearing these stacks pretty soon. The God Strength is coming out, pretty sure of it. And the wraparound is coming from Yang. They have the Necrobook 3. Yeah, they wanna come in and they pop the Exorcism as well. The smoke is gone. Here comes Triple Unite, he gets the time to Yang. Never GDC, no. Oh, here comes the winner and the all two stops of the enough. He's gonna find himself, not many kills, one Juggernaut, looking for double, triple units, he's brought down by FY and Juggernaut, yes, he will finally find a double, but he's gonna get chased down by End, and he's gonna blink out, but FY going crazy, going for the slow maybe, but LPC gonna get healed up, back to normal, healthy HP. And that was a crazy fight, it's a 3-for-1 trade, as you can see here, 1900. Oh, they even got the buyback forced out from the LC, who thought about going back in for more damage. So... alright, so FY have Opportunist and Faith may be thinking about going for the heal, but he does not have it. It's on cooldown. Meager plus 30 damage, and with this, the economy now is just pretty much thrown out of whack for VG Gaming RS. They has 5,000, you know, they have a 5,000 gold advantage. Death Prophet, like I said, has had quite a quiet game. Yang earned the level 3 Necrobooks. Maybe a blink. We might be seeing an AC. Vlad's if for more mid game dominance. And of course they can do Roche, but they need to just get one more kill on somebody. They just need to win one more team fight, Roche and high ground. For TongFu on the other hand, these guys need to smoke and catch like these cores who are still split up unaware. In VG Gaming they're like, whatever, screw it, we're just going straight. DC showing himself mid, actually no, he's just gonna casually go on the trees. It is nighttime, so they didn't see him. Nether Ward. Oh, this is gonna be a very fast Roche, especially with Alpha Wolf, who is not helping in. He jumps to stages.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Alright, so objective after objective just being taken away from VG Gaming. They're being taken away from TongFu, as they now they will try to attempt to trade take this team from the God Strength. First attack, there we go. Sven's gonna get himself a tower. Wanna fight the bottom before the God Strength expires, and they have to. They have to defend, they cannot give away this. And the Necrobooks probably have expired by now. And End is very low, but the healing ward is at level 1, so it's not gonna heal him up.
Radiant's top tower
still,
is under
not
attack.
As quickly as you would like. And Zeus with the BOTs didn't go for a blink dagger, and they will just back off, seeing as the whole of Punk would come back. A crit with God Strength. But okay, they get objective to get the trade, and nothing of much of value was lost. Still not an ideal trade, I mean, you do like, what, half damage to the tower. But maybe they'll try for a counter smoke now? Try for that, catching someone off guard in case. And this lane one's really very nice. DDC, what did he get? The Stormhammer, it's level 2. Always fun to see. And Faith is still going for something like a blade mail, it seems. I doubt it's an AC. And FY already has the Dragon Lantern making his way towards the full Aghanim Scepter, and by then, Sven is gonna have a very, very hard life. He's gone for the BKB, which is kind of awkward, I would feel. Because, I mean, you have a Sven, and you're playing against the Impetus damage, the Army Slash, the Roar. It seems like such a weird item choice. Yeah, he's waiting for him. He has a blink as well. He's comfortable with 4k. Yeah, 4k above 3.5? Yeah, to be exact. Comfortably above the Sven. And as a Sven, you know, you want to be just... especially with the cleave, you're supposed to have that network advantage. I have a feeling he's gonna say hi pretty soon, but nah, he's just waiting in the trees, hoping that his team will come back pretty soon. Because you see, the bottom lane is being pushed out. Mid and top lane are being pushed in. So DP 2.4k. I guess if you do need the, you know, BKB, it's gonna be on this guy. Just so that you can survive all the nukes. So 2.8k, maybe a Bloodstone. Still waiting for the Veil. Because that would, but that would legitimize the triple U9's BKB purchase.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Alright, so Lin. And the game has kind of slowed down. We're 17 to 15 at 24 minutes in before any fights happen. Let's take a quick look at your item progression overall. Yeah, nothing much. LPC trying to make his way towards that Aghanim, so that he's got a very, very healthy long suck from with no cooldown. Faye still making his way towards Blade Wheel, but he's picked up the Ogre Club, so that could be transition to a Halberd. You can transition to, yeah, BKB. Feels like a BKB. Diffusal already up on end, so this is for the Pugna Decrepify. And this is not going to save your Sven at all. And with 1.2k, maybe get a blink for more mobility so you can position your stuns better. And TongFu just had to play the I have faith in my carry game. Where he does farm safely around him or protect him and just kind of hope that. Yeah, you just kind of hope that he carries the team. And this is Sven after all. I mean, I'm pretty sure that you guys, you know, have been in those pub games where you just kind of had to deal with a Sven. Somehow your positioning just kind of messes up. He comes in with amazing cleans, wipes the team. Suddenly, out of nowhere, you find yourself on the back foot. Well, anyways, VG Gaming, they're coming back in. For this push on the bottom lane again, and they still have the Aegis, which should be expiring pretty soon. There we go, they will get the T3, and he's gonna take out another ward. Gonna fight this David for now. And here comes the roar, stopping LPC in the top, he's gonna be swapped out, and here comes the ult. There we go, Yang's gonna get destroyed by Triple Unite, and Juggernaut cleans up the leading commander. But the Exorcism doing a lot of damage, this is not the fight. There we go. Right, because Lin and she's gonna get saved by the recovery 5, but the user is saving him. Chance saving him from the trip of walking back to the fountain. And there we go, we need to buy back right now, but Death Prophet is not a hero who you want to buy back on because she just doesn't have the exorcism at all. And this will be the bottom lane. Right. And if anything, it should be another lane if you try to push for it. Okay, this will be buffed, so the regeneration is there. No one goes for a blink, so mobile Zeus. The game is just hard for TongFu. I mean, yeah, you're getting the kills. Alright, so if Ag just yet. Almost. Aw, such a pity. If End had given him, like, one of those creeps, he probably would have completed his Aghanims right there. You can tell he's pinging it. FY's pinging it. He's like, yo, dude. Please? Pretty please? Right, so anyways, back to this, he's going for a butterfly, and this just makes things harder for the Sven. I mean, at this point he can go for whatever item he wants, a basher, butterfly, Scotty. And has plenty of items which he can use to outplay this Sven, because he's just so far behind in farm. And like I mentioned, he went for the blink. No SNY, which we usually see, no AC, no Daedalus. And VG Gaming, they will smoke, but that was probably spotted out, yep, it was spotted out, but the reserve ward placed all the way over there. And TongFu, they camp away all the way in the base. As the Hawks scout things out, and they will just use the board to push the lane in. And they know. Yep, they definitely know. Alright, so Triple U9 just casually prodding his head outside, checking the guys. Swap me in, I have faith in you. And Yang's pushing in the bottom lane as well. Vladimir's offering almost completed. And they will just wait for the next Roshan, which is up in the next couple of minutes. Yep, they're scouting it out, checking in for wards as well. And TongFu just turtling in the base. No, Confu should say, Hei Shan says, K, Yang. And anyways, We almost have a butterfly completed. Any other core items popping up? Well, the BKB is up on the Death Prophet, which she desperately needs. Let's see. No, I think they just wasted too much time, like with the Nether Wards. Using the Salt for that and the Decrepify was not worth it. And here we go, meanwhile, 5 men smoke. They're going to try for the Desperation play. Can they find Yang, who does blink away? And the Hawks got it out. I think so, because everyone's off the map. So VG Gaming, they're just playing very, very safe. And TongFu, they're like, I'm pretty sure I saw them around there. Just waiting. Oh. And now they know what's going on. They find everything. They find everybody. Exit will be popped. And the road will go to Zip. But he gets popped out by DDR. And here goes the going. But where's this man? But it's only going to be the support on DDC. And then, off of the healing ward right now, they're going to catch up with you. 9 rounds. So much. And his DKB is not even going to matter. Anyway, nope. Winner, winner, you lose. Nonetheless, it has to be a team up in the enemy jungle. And TongFu will call GG. Game 1 goes the way of VG Gaming Reborn.
Radiant.
So not exactly the ideal ending. That was quite a messy fight. You can tell that was pretty much, you know, that was quite a desperate play from TongFu. But anyways, my name is Hades. We'll be back for game 2 shortly. Stay tuned.